Hello, I am Mary Ellen Barbera, Chief Judge of Maryland's State Courts. On August 31, if the health data trends remain stable or continue to improve, the Maryland Judiciary will move carefully into the fourth phase of court operations. In phase four, the courts will be back to full operations with the exception of jury trials. This means that the courts will resume hearing a broader range of matters, including non-jury trials and contested hearings in criminal, civil, and family and juvenile cases. Although I have said it in previous messages, I must again thank you. The last nearly 6 months have been difficult ones, and the future months may present more challenges. However, extraordinary levels of patience and collaboration have made it possible to handle the matters that must be heard and to perform the core functions of the judiciary. Thank you for making access to justice possible during the health emergency. Through phase four, and as necessary into phase five, we will continue to monitor, evaluate, and respond to any changes in the COVID-19 infection rates. We will continue to follow COVID-19 health precautions, including requiring the wearing of masks, maintaining distance, and temperature checks at building entrances. Phase five will begin in early October. Then we will be able to resume jury trials, but only if the pandemic has been sufficiently suppressed to allow them. The phased resumption of operations will combine health measures with operations to serve the justice needs of the people of Maryland. The judiciary's new normal will look different because it incorporates measures needed to protect the health of court visitors and personnel. If you have not already done so, please visit the judiciary's webpage dedicated to COVID-19 at the web address located at the bottom of this screen. The website will provide you with resources, updates, and important information on the progressive phased reopening so that you may gain a better understanding of what the resumption of operations may mean for you. Judiciary personnel and those visiting courthouses and other facilities are required to comply with health protocols to help prevent the transmission of COVID-19. Please help us protect your health by continuing to put into practice basic health measures urged by the Maryland Department of Health and the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. When you visit one of our courthouses or facilities, you will see many reminders, either on courthouse monitors or posters, emphasizing these exact guidelines and requirements. The courts are requiring any individual, including employees, seeking access to a courthouse or court office location to abide by four specific requirements: answering a set of COVID-19 screening questions, allowing security teams to perform no-contact temperature checks, wearing a facial covering or mask at all times, and maintaining social distancing by staying at least 6 feet apart whenever possible. If you are denied access to a court building or court office, you will be provided information about possible alternatives, including remote attendance, if available, or rescheduling, if appropriate. I cannot stress enough how important it is that you take these requirements seriously. Thank you in advance for your cooperation. Those of you who do not have lawyers may need some guidance navigating the court's reopening plan. For assistance, please contact the Maryland Courts Self-Help Center. You can find the contact information at the bottom of this screen. The center may be able to obtain no-cost legal assistance, either by phone or via online chat services, for certain civil matters. We are carefully easing closer into full operations, but please be aware that there is no operating business as usual. We have a new regular means of operation and are adapting technology, services, and processes to deliver our mandate to you, the people we serve. We will continue to work together to keep you informed and as much as is possible under the circumstances to provide the access to the court that you need during the COVID-19 emergency. Please monitor the judiciary's COVID-19 website for the latest statewide and local court information. Thank you for watching. Please stay safe and well.